Laban din expecting, siguro may losing tools. Okay? Okay. In this session, at the end of the session, you are expected to be able to revisit the nature of classroom observation, its protocols, tools, and key players. Okay. And review some of the classroom observable indicators relative to the implementation of the Matatang curriculum. So we'll be experiencing a different classroom monitor, classroom observation, because this is in the initial implementation of the Matatag curriculum. And then, you will also refine the prepared lesson plan based on the indicators presented leading to the demonstration teaching. Right now, you are grouped according to your the subject area. We have the grade 1, as in yung grade 1. And I believe meron na kayo mag-demont teaching mamaya. Meron na. And then you already prepared your lesson plan. Mathematics. And dito yung mathematics. Science. TLE. Grade 1. Kindergarten. Hindi ako lang kindergarten. Ano pa yung isang subject natin? Yung natin. Yes. Yeah, so meron na mag-demont. Good. And also, on the other hand, we will also target the professional standards and silos. For teachers, we have domain 1, content knowledge and pedagogy, and we have 1.1, 1.4, 1.5, 1.6. May teacher ba tayong participants today? Wala, no? May master teacher. Okay. And, ayan pa yung domain 4. The curriculum and planning, magka-cascade na po kayo sa division ninyo at the school, this will be the target for the professional standards for teacher participants. And for school heads, nasa ba din kayo mga school heads? School heads, pag-itas po, pinag-arapan niyo po yun. Oo, di ba? Nakatakot-takot na ranking. Para lang mabigyan kayo ng item at saka yung entrance exam. So be proud. Okay, ito yung po yung itatarget natin. Domain 3, focusing on teaching and learning. Particularly 3.2, the teaching standards and pedagogies. 3.2.2, provide technical assistance to teachers on teaching standards and pedagogies within and across learning areas. And engage the school personnel such as master teachers and chaka head teachers as well. And also for our supervisors, as yung mga supervisors natin, be proud also kasi pinaglarapan din natin yan. Diba? Particularly in domain 3, fostering a culture of continuous improvement. Particularly 3.1, support for instructional leadership. Apply a program instructional leadership support strategies to help division, district schools and learning centers with a continuous improvement of teaching and learning process. And mentor and coach colleagues in adopting relevant instructional leadership support strategies to address harmonized needs of classroom division, district schools and our learning. And in this session, this is our session to know first. Hindi pa siya naman. Ayan. We will solicit the group experiences on managing classroom observation. I believe all of you here already conducted classroom observation. Tama? Yes. Tama. Hopefully lahat dito mapakalir na nagka-classroom observation na hindi ito nagiging source of anxiety and pain to teachers. I don't know kasi pag sinabi natin classroom observation, bakit yung mga teachers natatakot? Ganun di ba kayo yung when you're still a teacher? you feel anxious, but kinobserbahan tayo ng mga principal, supervisor, or kung sino lang may trip na mag-observe sa atin. Wala naman siguro, no? Na trip ko yan na mag-observe. And also, we will reflect the challenges and opportunities brought by classroom observation. Then after that, we will also be discussing local and international literature on classroom observation, criteria for effective teaching evaluation, the CO protocols, CO tools, and CO indicators. Are you already familiar with the COT or the classroom observation tools, most especially our students? No? Are you already familiar? Memorize the deal because every teacher dapat meron CO because it's being used for their performance. No? But hopefully this one, our classroom observation, in the initial implementation of the TAD curriculum, we will look at this as a room for improvement and for technical assistance in the implementation of the TAD curriculum. And of course, at the end, you will refine the lesson plan or exemplar based on the indicators presented and executed through demonstration teaching. I was just going to be discussing here 2 hours, hopefully. And then, after that, pag we break out session na tayo, then pupunta tayo sa each breakout room for your demo teaching. Mamaya, all of you, may mga part kami. May mga part kayo, anong part ninyo? Okay. Before we proceed to the discussion of classroom observation, let's do this activity first. Within your group, you share your experiences in managing classroom observation. And somebody will summarize your experiences, and mamaya, we will be sharing your experiences in classroom observation. Can I request the PMT for 10 and the meta part? Okay, in 2 minutes, I'll give you 2 minutes to share with your group and your experiences in conducting classroom observation. Your time starts now. Din mamaya, Kung sino ang bet nyo na mag-present, siya yung mag-present. So I'll just give you 2 minutes to share within your group your experiences in managing classroom or observation. And summarize your profile by writing a hashtag in the card. Hashtag Mameli, hashtag Hopefully. Okay, can I request the PLT na parang ibigay yung isang metacard na per group? O sige, mag-brainstorming na kayo in your group or makikilala po ba kayo? Magkakaibigan po ba kayo? O isa na. So, ipapower po yung inyo kung sino PowerPoint, ipo-point kung sino ang mag-share pangala. O kaya, yung main one, okay na? So yung mag-share yung nasa inyo ba? Kung sino may tawag ng meta card, siya yung mag-share. So mamaya, baka mamaya yung meta card, plus mamaya, kulong-kulong yun na. with basa-basa. If that we mean na wasa tagain ito meta pa.
Mapi Ganin! they have mastery. They have mastery in the next one. And in terms of strategy, usually teachers also integrate ICT, VR, technology, and then they have these learning activities in order for them that the learners is enjoying and that it is engaging. So we have especially in physical education, they are using rubrics and they usually practical activities in physical education. And then students also are part in the collaborative assessment. So in physical education or in mapping as a whole, usually ang mga kabataan is mga aktibo. With that, thank you so much.
Basta!
Sabay-sabay na uli. Basta!
Mapigaling!
Okay, mapigaling. Then let's group. Sino po yung mag-group po?
Good morning, sir. For CETTLE, we have hashtag inspiring. I'd like to share our experiences in managing and developing user vision. This is our collaborative expertise or experience in our developing user vision. For number one, we identify that the teacher should be informed well of this agent for classroom observation. Then, there is a pre-conference. We have to discuss the details of what to do to the classroom observation. Then, your presentation of the classroom observation board in papers. Kasi yung pagtitingnan natin, sa delusion yung nakakulay. Then, we proceed to the classroom observation. After that event, we will be sharing our results. It will be the next actions during the event. We will be possibly probably asking this what, when. We will be asking the teacher anong nangyari sa kanyang and then the past observer will have to provide technical assistance also. Then, after that, a slide design that we needed to conduct the course as a future ways or forms of development for the next class
presentation. Thank you so much. Parang wala na ako ang nag-discuss. Nayan na ni sir. Okay, inspired. Meron na tayong doon. Satisfying, ma-active, galing, inspired. How about grade 1? Oh, challenging, I like that. What challenging yung hashtag na grade 1?
Okay, so we have our collaboration in coming up with this hashtag. So our hashtag is challenge. So classroom observation will be challenging to all of us, to the observers, the situation leaders, to the teachers being observed. Why? Number one, we get into a way of subjectivity because somehow different observers might have different aspects of having conducting the observation. And another challenge is the preparation, the timing,
So these are the challenges to be considered in having an effective and efficient observation. Thank you even more. Hashtag challenging Green One Guru. Ayan, galing naman. So, I believe hindi na ako may kailangan dito through the discussion of my topic. So, your hashtag, lumabas daw na merong satisfying, ang galing, and then may challenge, definitely. So, lumabas din doon yung collaboration. Lumabas din sa presentation na kung sino ang involved sa class of observation. We have the teacher and the learner. And of course, the topic group, lumabas din yung mga strategies na ginagamit ng teacher. And particularly doon sa grade 1, the challenges in conducting the classroom observation. And this will be our gist in the discussion of classroom observation. Okay ba yung activity natin? Yes. Pagdating yung ano natin, yung upuan natin. Sa nagsabi ng collaboration, pero lumangas ang power of pointing. Okay. Hindi na naman siya lumang. Clark?
Ayaw niya.
Thank you so much. Tapos na. So, what is classroom observation? So, bago ibigay ng definition, because we will be discussing international and local literature on what is classroom observation. Ano po yung classroom observation? In your own honest opinion,
classroom observation is a way of assessing and validating the teacher's strategies.
Yes. Okay. Validating the teacher's strategy. Okay. One definition of classroom observation. Mr. Reed, sir.
Educators observing each other's practice, providing feedback and learning from each other to improve their impact of students' learning.
Educators observing each other's practice. The second, who will read Sekarande?
Also, improving teacher practice in alignment with governments and school, region, state level of priorities.
Thank you, sir. And the third definition, ma'am.
Aims to make classroom practice more visible and encourage colleagues to collaborate to improve teacher practice and student learning.
The definition comes from Australian Institute of Teaching and School Leadership. So in this definition, we can say that classroom observation aims to improve the teaching and learning process for the improvement of our learner. Kumbaga, classroom observation not aim to see the flaws or observe the flaws of the teacher. It aims to improve the teaching and learning process. Okay, we still have another definition. Doon naman ako sa likod. Sir?
What is ensuring quality teaching?
Ensuring quality teaching. And hindi ba ako mag-upay patira mga Einstein? Sir Kenny?
A process of providing feedback for a teacher's classroom practice.
A process of giving feedback. And my friend, Sir John Ray, nakabasa pa ba?
Encourages teachers to reflect and develop self-awareness
practice.
Reflect and develop self-awareness about their own practice. Ang gagaling ng mga friend ko, ayos pa yung mga nakaka. Then, yung pang-apat na definition, ma'am.
Provides evidence of actual teacher performance. Their strength is the end. Area, sabi mo po.
O, di ba ang malinder pa yung mga participant ko sa kanila? Okay, if what provides evidence of actual teacher's performance. Though the test of observation may be used for the RPMS, but then again, we have to look at it as an avenue for critical assistance to our teachers. Okay? Then, the criteria for an effective teaching evaluation. Sino ba yung magbabasa? Bernardo? My friend?
Teachers' evaluation should be based on professional teaching standards and should be sophisticated enough to assess teaching quality across the continuum of development from novice to expert teachers by Darling and 2012.
Thank you, Bernard. Okay, based on professional standards, and we have the professional standards already, and we have the new teacher to proficient teacher. Now, can you recall our classroom observation protocol? We have protocols, right? In classroom observation. We're not conducting classroom observation just because that is based on our PRA, and you are bored at that time and you're doing nothing, and you decided to visit a teacher and observe his or her class. We're not doing that. Oh, kasi trick ko lang, kung nag-ubi naman ako mag-classroom observation, lugod ako, pagtuon ko yung teacher, kaya mga pagsulod niya, mahusay niya ba ano, napaka mahusay, ito sa lugo. We have protocols to that. Kanina, si, sa group na EBBTLB, initially actually, give us the protocol in classroom observation. Kaya sabi ko, hindi na ako mahihirapan kasi alam na ninyo ito. But sometimes we have to remind ourselves again to review some protocols in classroom observation. Well, three actually protocols lang. In the monitoring, in the initial implementation of Matagal curriculum, one, lesson preparation. Kanina ako dito, sir, we have to give, ask the teacher kung kaya siya pwede mag-observahan. So, there is a prior notice. But sometimes, pwede na tayo mag-informal. Dumaan lang tayo. Kasi ang galing na pala ng mga natin, ang nakatay na natin, that's important. But in the formal class of observation, we inform prior our teacher. And the second one, the lesson execution. So I'm doing that. And then, the post-conference. After the observation, we will be conducting post-conference. In no way that you are not ready your class observation, hindi po tayo mag-post-conference. Oh, just like what happened sa akin. This is my personal personal experience. Na-observe ako, doon na-follow yung number one and number two, pero wala ng post-conference kasi na-busy naman. May valid reason kasi pinatawag sa principal's office and siguro may kainan doon and then nakalimutan na ang post-conference. So ano daw lang? So hopefully, in our monitoring, so dapat hindi natin makalimutan mo post-conference. Huwag natin iwan ang teacher sa ERE na mag-iisip siya ano kaya ang nangyari sa performance ko maganda ba ang naging performance ko? And then, wala namang follow-up. Okay, so, ito yung mga protocols natin. Principal, masigaan po tayo ka-busy. Pwede naman pagka-following day mag-post conference, di ba tama? After a week, pwede pa pag-post conference. Yes. After a month, pwede pa ba? Wala na no after a month. After a quarter, wala na no. Hindi na pwede mag-post conference. How about mag-post conference tayo immediately after? Pwede yun?
Okay, sige.
Mamaya, aalay natin kung pwede at immediately after. Okay. In the classroom observation, we have observation tools. You are familiar with this. Sa akin, when I'm still a teacher, a different tool ang ginagamit. Yung RPMS, ano pa ba yung iba pa? Basta hindi na yun sa ngayon. Because we have the classroom observation tool or masikat sa FB, COB. Di ba COB? Yung mga teacher na po-post ay done ready with the COB. Di ba? Andiyan.
CO lang.
Tapos na ako sa COB. So si teacher ang nag-gumagawa ng COB. Class Observation Tool. Kasi tool ang nag-ready, di ba? Napapansin niyo ba yun? So, appropriately, kung mag-post ay done with COB. Central office. Galing kasi siya ng central office. Class observation. So, familiar kayo sa mga class observation tool. Most especially sa mga principal natin in school level. At saka yung master teacher. So, we have here, based on the Philippine Professional Standards, the classroom observation tool, and we have the classroom observation notes form. Are you familiar with this?
Yes.
Yes. Ora-ora na na. And of course, this one, the classroom observation tool, we have the rating sheet and the enter server agreement form. Also familiar din kayo. Ako hindi naman familiar dito kasi hindi naman kami ng office. Kahit na tumabanyan ka ng principal, sumunod na kami nga ito, mag-observe ako. Lakan nyo, lakan ng hangin, naging kaon, na mag-observe man. So, wala lang sa muna yung lahat ng protocol. Okay. And now, who are our classroom observers? Sino kaya ang classroom observers natin? Student, yes. Master teachers, supervisor, correct? So, in short, all instructional? Yes. All instructional leaders. At sino-sino sila? The mga classroom leaders. We have, yes, master teacher, head teachers, principal, public school district supervisor, education program supervisor, in the division, walang po si Rachel. So, kasi hindi na po namin PRD yun. No, in the context of RPMS, only the school-based instructional leaders are allowed to rate the teacher as per DOE 2015. So, hindi pa mag-rate si PSDS at si APS. Only the school-based instructional leaders. Who are they? Master teacher, head teacher, and school head. Department head, meron na kayong department head. Sila lang po ang mag-re-rate. Pagkaman gusto ni PSDS na mag-rate, katin-katin siyang mag-rate, so hindi po siya pwede mag-rate. Okay? Lalo. Yes. The presence of division instructional leaders during normal or regular classroom observation only provide technical assistance to the school head. Yan po ha, klaro. Si PSDS will not go directly to the teacher on his or her observation, but to the school head. Bakit kaya? Sir, what's the wisdom behind?
Because our religion, first of all, home to supervisor is the heads, not the teachers.
Yes. Tama po nga. So yung direkta po ninyo ay yung school head. So you're just only there to oversee the flow of yung observation and as a whole yung school, kung ano ang mga observation nyo. So itidirect siya sa school head. Now it's the work of the school head to give that information to the teacher. Okay? So wag po natin ipaipas si school head. Even in the visit kapag visit, yung monitoring, if you are PSDS just like us, we immediately proceed to the principal's office. Hindi kami pupunta doon sa classroom. Or, pupunta muna kami sa division office, magpapapicture sa SDS. Sa ASDS, yun po yung protocol namin. Pa-picture para pumunta po kami doon. And then sa CID chief, sa SGOD chief. So ang dami namin picture. And then pupunta na kami sa principal. And then yung mga matanda, parang satellite yan. Tingin-tingin niya, tingin, moving pa yung mga mata ko. And then that's the time that we have to share observation to the student. Ayan, ito yung protocol. Division, is to principal or school head. Principal or school head to master teachers. Principal, school head to teacher. And then head teacher to teacher. Ito yung ano, yung process, no? But, meron ba itong pwede natin i-break yung process nito? In my own personal point of view, yes. Kasi, kung immediate naman yun, na nakita mo, halimbawa, may nangyari sa classroom, hihintayin mo pa ba si principal na naandun ka na? Di ba mayroon ganoon? Eh? Kung kailangan mo na talaga mag-intervene, then do it, PSDS. Kung need lang. Pero kung okay ba, so we have to start to the monitoring and coaching. Actually, may debate kami sa region kasi sa monitoring, hindi talaga kami ng direction doon. But we have the initiative from the regions and the division. We have Project GIA and the other projects, di ba? This part of the question, first, those interventions from the region, if it will still continue or not in the implementation of the Makatag curriculum, if it's still helpful or not. Ang dami ng buti mo. Asan ba dito yung ano? Wala naman dito siguro yung brain behind the Project Ian Luther Ryan. So baka pumunta siya dito. Okay. Reminders for observers. What not to do. So ano ang di dapat gawin ng mga observer during the observation? Number one, do not bring the lesson plan. This is in the context of Makatag curriculum. Ha? Do not bring the lesson plan. The COT rubrics, huwag dalhin. The rating sheet, the inter-observer agreement form during the lesson delivery. Ano lang ang dadalhin ng observer? Yes. Only the observation notes ang dadalhin. So yun lang. So, do not ask for the lesson plan, the COT, only the observation form. Before, yung nagkakandak ng observation, papasok, hihingin ang lesson plan. Where's your lesson plan? Nataranta si teacher, wala, sira na lahat. Or, mahiba, for example, kasi schedule naman yung class observation. Nag-allocate tayo ng chair sa likod or sa uncomfortable ng observer and then nilalagay doon yung lesson plan. But right now, we are not into the content of the lesson. It is on how the teacher delivers the lesson. Yung.
Number two,
do not talk with your fellow observers in the entire duration of the demonstration. Huwag ay mag-iistoryahan. Huwag ay magmamanifest. So focus on the observation. Huwag chika-chika lahat ay ano. Why is the reason? Kasi it might, yes, distract the teacher. Kasi pinipigilingin pa ako ng hira, ano pa ako, kaya ba ako
Then number three,
refrain from discouraging facial expressions, the non-verbal communication. Itataas ang hira, yung mga negative na facial expression, pati yung mag-smile. O ayun ang mga... Or... Pagkawalay. Bakit ang teacher tumago ng halingan kung ano? Ano? So, we have to avoid that one.
And then, number four, do not conduct the first conference right after the demo.
Do not. This is in the context of nakatag curriculum. Do not. Huwag mo nang mag-post-conference kasi baka may klase pa si teacher. Diba? Natawagin mo si teacher, sige mag-post-conference na tayo. You have your notes, your observation notes for. So I think hindi yan mawawala. So, maybe lunchtime or kagwasan na si teacher ay kalmado na. Hindi basta-basta rin yung pag-observaran ka mo, especially if three ang mag-observe sa'yo. Kung isa lang, okay na. But I really don't know, when it comes to class observation, skeptical ng ating mga teachers. Even me, actually. And I don't know, some of you, when you were still a classroom teacher, you feel anxious. Not anxious actually, but there are some that they are very much confident and they want another teacher or their school head give feedback on the way they teach. May mga ganoon din. Ako before, when I was still teaching at Lady Normal University, the late Dr. Presby Chan Rinsara just informed us that within this week, she will be conducting a classroom observation. And then, I don't know what time, because there's one professor also asked if there is a specific schedule kung kailan siya, and she just only answered us, I don't own my schedule. So that ibig sabihin, that whole week you prepare. So, pag-andam na lang. And then, when Ma'am Gonzaga, pumasok na sa classroom ko and I was in the middle of my discussion already, buti na lang na andun yung, ano ko, yung lesson plan ko sa side. Diyos ko, Lord, kung pwede na lang tumago ako because yun si Ma'am Crispy Gonzaga. Alam ko kasi kakaibig ako ng buhay ni Ma'am Gonzaga. And then, she, ano lang, after that, kapagalang hinay-hinay lang yung paggawas. And that's the time, wala akong na ang doon ang mayayang hindi mag-insaga. Iwari mo kami ng post-conference. But when she leave my room, naka-smile pa niya. So, I take it as parang I did good, siguro. But walang post-conference. And here comes, I'll just share this experience also in ILS. The school head and the principal in ILS also tell us na mag-observe siya. And at that time, I'm very excited kasi I don't know kung ano nakain ko na very excited ako. I went to her office and then pinasign ko yung lesson plan ko. And then, what time ka papasok? Kasi prepared ako. Katuko ko yung mamparaya o laking. And she just answered me, I don't know because we have a meeting. We have a meeting with the president. So, kakakampanin na ako. And then here comes, pumasok siya, nag-observe siya. So, hindi ko na ibigay yung lesson plan because I was already in the middle of my discussion. Kumbaga, pag-ana ng pagpinundok, yung mga kakayaw ko lang lang. Okay ko lang ang mga strategies. May impagawas ko pang picture ni Rosalinda. At that time, inumuhoyan ako kaya na pag-ganya kasi Filipino teacher. Then after that, wala namang post-conference. Pinatawag na lang kami lang isa-isa. So, what do you tell? Kasi it's a very, issue. So, walang post-conference. And here comes, yun na. Kapag naiwan ka sa ere, and then, yun. Nag-end ang career ko sa Lady Normal University, in short. But, in the actual, kasi I was still very young at that time, wow, and fresh. The proper way to do that is you let your teachers know the flows yung pagtuturo niya so that that teacher will grow. Diba? Do not use that one as a weapon. Oh my God, a weapon against the teacher. Okay? Because it's against the civil service law, first and foremost. But anyways, we are in the hands of the powerful gods and goddesses at that time. So, thank you. That, yeah, best of observation and protocols, we have a list of preparation, the jury, and the post conference. Now, what are the classroom observable indicators? And I will be discussing here some of the indicators. But there are some also that outside the parameters of these indicators, outside the parameters that you can use as basis for the RPMS of the teacher or the IPCR. Okay, we have here. Apply knowledge of content within a cross-curricular teaching teaching areas. The food is being served now. Enjoy your food. See you. Then number two, use a range of teaching strategies. Kanina nasabi ng mapping group. 1.5, apply a range of teaching strategies to develop critical and creative thinking. Ito ba yung naano natin lang sa CLT niyo? Are you familiar with this?
Yes.
Display proficient use of mother tongue, Filipino, English to facilitate teaching and learning. Plan, manage, and implement sequence teaching and learning process to meet curriculum requirements. Ito ba yung tinitinan nyo din sa teacher niyo sa CLT 4? Yes, sa CLT 2. Select, develop, organize, and use appropriate teaching and learning resources, including ICT to address learning goals. Nandun si ICT. Design, select, organize, to use diagnostic, formative, and summative assessment. So, andun din, I think na-discuss na sa inyo yung formative and summative assessment. Ah, sino po yung na-discuss ng task assessment? Si Dr. Porsche. Na, sino yung mag-ano natin? Sino gumawa ng lesson plan? Makitaas na yung tamay. Yung magde-demo. Sige, sino magde-demo ng mga? Pakita yung mo.
Ha?
Nag-prepare na. Science. Ay, andun si ma'am. Huwag nyo na mo sa nag-prepare. Dito si ma'am.
Ang
dalawa. 4 and 7 na yes. Oo. Then, 7. Papel. Andun din nag-prepare. Then, si IPPTLE. Nag-prepare din. So, ano mo ba ang ano, isi-sensory na lahat ng mga gumawa ng lesson plan wala dito? Ayaw isa dito. O, sino lang ang alam natin dito? Ah, dito din sa green one. Sino green one? O, ayan. Ito kasi kami yung, o, pagkano talaga rin sa... I'll be proud kasi binigyan po kayo ng chance na mag-shine. It's your moment to shine. Marami pong nabago ng buhay dahil sa demo teaching. Yung iba pinakausap na ang sarili. Yung iba naman na promote. Oo, di ba? Yung iba naman na promote. It's your moment para pumaraya. Di ba? Okay. So, dalawa lang ang situation natin sa ginawa ni yung lesson plan. Hindi ano, dapat sama-sama pa kayong gumawa ng lesson plan? Or you just ask somebody to make the lesson plan? Huwag kang mag-alala, yun din ang ginawa namin sa national. Di ka nag-iisa. Sige. But anyway, you're a run-through lang natin because hindi naman natin masisensyuin kasi wala doon yung very clear lesson plan. I'm very sorry though because that's the kung hindi nyo po makita, imagine nyo lang. Huwag nyo pong pigitin na makita, baka po masira ang mga mata ninyo. This is the lesson plan in reading and literacy grade 1. We'll just use this sample lesson plan to sensory the indicators. Kung saan yung tingnan yung mga indicators. Okay. For the preparation of lesson. Now, let's proceed. I'll give you a session. Ayan. Hindi na po nakikita. Hindi ko na papapasa. Mediator 1, apply knowledge of content within and across curriculum teaching areas. How do you rate this one? Diba we have rating from 1 to 9 or 7?
7 for proficiency.
7 for professional teaching.
And ladies and gentlemen, datang natin ang mga sasayalan niya because our Matatag journey is made more wonderful because we have with us the Director 4 of the PHROD from the Office of the Director. Please welcome, let's give a hand to Attorney Risky Siosan.
Because I want to see how you guys are doing. Kumusta ka mo? Ano man? Kumusta ka IPO? Pero nakamukaanlaw? Four days. Pinapakaon ka mo niya, no? Okay naman. It's always a pleasure being with fellow Warais. No? I may seldom interact with the Warayons, but rest assured that as a Warayon, my heart is always with Agent A. Anyway, I know that you guys are aware that there are so many things happening right now in the department. You know about that? All these roll-outs ng Matata, we're also doing our part in the HR. And I hope that with all these changes that's happening, we will all be at our best, no, in cooperating with the agency in the department. Simply because at the end of the day, when there is a change or when there are changes done, it is always characterized by a bit of chaos. But when there is chaos, after the chaos, there is already the progress or the change that emerges. So, as far as we are concerned, or as far as the VP is concerned, no, she is trying to do everything as she has promised to the Filipino people. By the way, I don't know if you know it already, but DepEd has again emerged as the most trusted agency in the whole of our nation. So thank you, ladies and gentlemen. With your hard work, we are emerging as the foremost agency in government right now, in the Philippine government. With the leadership of our secretary and the cooperation of each and every one of you, we are sure that what we have been in the past will no longer be the same in the coming future. Diba? So, if you again consider the problems that we are experiencing right now, you are at the forefront of the solution of these problems, right? I know that it is awful that we are near bottom in terms of our performance in the international assessments that we have been doing, no? Yung PISA, dalawa, 2018 and then 2025 or 2021. We're at the near bottom. In 2018, we were at the bottom. Right now, we are at the near bottom. So at least, umangat tayo ng konti. And this is the response that the department has decided to do in order to change that equation. You see, hindi ho pwede yung dati. We need to change. And each and every one of us here is needed to effect that change. So, if it is a bit uncomfortable at this point, please bear with that discomfort, because at the end of the day, this is for our children and the children of our children and the future of our nation. So, wala na ho tayong pababaan pa, kasi nasa baba na ho tayo dati. Yeah? So all that we are going to do now is to go to the top once more, no? And slowly but surely, with all this and the cooperation, as I said, of everyone, I am sure there is no way but up for the Republic of the Philippines and the Department of Education for that time. Rest assured that we are doing everything, hindi lang po sa curriculum, hindi lang sa training ng teachers, but we're also doing everything we can to help our personnel. Lahat. I just came from Cebu because we are doing the second batch of the personnel audit. We are now doing personnel audit because this is a sad story a little bit, but you know, I have to tell you this, no? When I first arrived in the department, a year ago. The first question I had to my team at the HR is, do you have a database of all employees? And the answer given to me is, sorry sir, central office na po, meron. And I was shocked. Because do you know how many we are right now in the entire department? Do you know our number? Last year when I arrived, we were at 1,025,000. Or 1,020,000. Right now, we are at 1,030,000. And this coming year, or maybe this year, we will be 1,055,000. Because we will be adding more or less 20,000 positions and another 5,000 admin position, officer positions. No? And yet, it is not sufficient. We know that it is not enough. But just like anything, it is the budget that is a problem. With such a huge bureaucracy that we have, DepEd actually is the highest, or maybe second highest branch or no, department in the government in terms of budget. Napakalaki ho ng budget ng DepEd. And yet, it is not sufficient. But we are addressing everything. Now, we are not going to sit down and just relax. We are trying to address everything. Remember also, guys, that in the coming years, or maybe next year, there will be the so-called government right-sizing program. Okay? I am also involved in the bill right now. It is also already being thrown around. People are there already consulting. But it does not mean that right sizing will actually chop people off from positions. No? Right sizing means putting the correct number of people to perform the job as necessary in order for a particular department to be effective in its mandates. So in the case of DepEd, hindi ho ang right sizing sa atin pagkatiyas. Sa tingin ko, dapat ang right sizing sa atin pagdagdag. Kasi, do you know how many learners we have right now? No? We have about 28 million learners being serviced by 1,030,000 employees. Simple na lang mo, ilagay na lang muna natin sa 1 million. So ang lumalabas, 1,028,000. Diba? So one person serves, simple lang yan ha, one person serves 28 learners. Diba, it's already a bit difficult.
Okay.
And we have to address everything. Now, We have started doing, I don't know if you have heard about it already or if you learned about it. I know that you have read it. No? I mean, not just perhaps in its entirety for some of you, but it is out there already. The admin tasks of teachers are already been released. But we're coming up with the nitty-gritties, it's coming up also para ma-address na muna natin yung mga tanong. And of course, just like any problem that is being addressed, marami po ang mga tanong sa nilalabas namin. Lalabas din muna natin soon, hopefully, yung BSc. This is for the teachers, no? And then other requirements for our teachers so that they can focus on teaching. And that is the... But hindi ho namin kinakalimutan yung mga hindi naman teachers yung mga teaching related. Meron din ho tayo doon, no? It's just that we're doing everything at the same time, no? We're trying to address all these problems at the same time. And that is why, again, as I said, all we ask from you is patience and understand. And we also would like to ensure to assure everyone that you are heard. the PHROD under my jurisdiction, the director, the office of the director is ready and willing to entertain any of your thoughts, no, any of your concerns. But in my, this just bear in mind the so-called hierarchy of office. The central office cannot solve everything for you. We should also learn how to use our the hierarchy, no? Levels of governance. Okay? So I know that it has been a feeding program for the past 4 days already. I think next time, before pumasok, dapat ay tibahan. Yeah, you have to feed our bodies also and our brains before we can do our thing. So I hope that we are all from Region 8 here naman, no? Wala naman from other regions. Mr. Samar, may I look at the delegation? Can I say, okay, I studied with Mr. Samar. Okay, Mr. Samar. What about Northern Samar? Ayan. What about Western? Western Samar. And then, Leyte. Ayan. Southern Leyte. Ano mo, ikulay? Gusto mo yan? Hindi yung nasa isang kumpul lang kayo, no? Sino pang hindi? Bilira. And then, sino pang hindi? Ah, Borongan City. Sino? Ayan. Borongan. Yeah, I studied in Borongan. And, bye-bye. And, Aasim. Kalbaloga. Kalbayo. And, Tacloban. Orlo, sorry, Orlo and Tacloban. Ayan. Wala pa bang bagong city tayo? Okay. Alam nyo, alam ko na ang ano, ang Region 8 magagaling. Kaya, nakikita ko naman. Kaya kayo na nandito, kayo ang pinakamagagaling sa magagaling. Let's continue our journey towards the, for the benefit of our learners and the future of our country. And I hope that you will not, hindi nyo kayo magsasawa sa pagkulong at sa papanatiling at sa utak natin kung ano ang dapat natin gawin para sa pamakanan ng mga anak at mga anak ng mga anak natin. There is nothing more important than being a parent. And or being or having kids with you, no, that you can hope for the future. So remember, however hard it is that you feel you're doing right now, no, you feel frustrated, etc. However small you feel your contribution or nil, yung tipong feeling nyo, wala naman ako, wala naman nangyayari sa ginagawa ko, please continue doing it. Because kahit yung nabuhok na nagawa nyo, kahit akala nyo wala, may impact yan, hindi nyo lang namakalayan. At ang magiging result ko niyan, makikita nyo sa mga anak at mga anak ninyo. Kayo ho, ang nagpupunla ang ating mga anak, ang magbe-benefit at magliling ng ating ipinunla kayong mga araw nito at sa susunod araw. Kaya ho dyan, salamat ho at hindi ko na ho patatagalin ang inyong activity. Maraming salamat at makausap ko rin kayo. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Attorney Risti, COCS, the Director for the VHROD Central Office. At isa lang natin makasama ang ating mga katuwang sa pag sa ating paglalakbay sa mga tagad na Department of Education. Kaya naman, we need to document this. Let's have a full opportunity with Attorney Risti, COCS, together with our Nega family from the Central Office of Bang there are nail monitors, awareness, sacred and rich.